Valentia. Northeast, 2 knots, fair, 15 miles, 1,015, rising. Belmullet, northwest, 6 knots, fair, 9 miles, 1,013, rising. And finally, Dublin Airport. West to northwest, 6 knots, fine, 16 miles, 1,012, rising. That's it for me for now. Have a great night, everyone.
From the newsroom, I'm Martin Frawley. Air Force One, with US President Joe Biden on board, has departed from Ireland West Airport in Knock in County Mayo following the President's four-day trip to Ireland. Speaking to reporters at the airport, Mr. Biden said he has already made up his mind to run for the presidency again and will announce soon. Taoiseach Leo Varadkar was at the airport to formally bid farewell to Mr. Biden. Earlier, Mr. Biden addressed what the White House estimated was a crowd of 27,000 outside St. Murdoch's Cathedral in Ballina. He told the crowd that this was the time to lay the foundations brick by brick for a better future for our kids and grandkids. Mr. Biden said that now is a time of enormous possibilities. The President made reference to his visit earlier in the day to Mayo Roscommon Hospice, where there was a plaque to his late son, Beau, who died of cancer in 2015. Earlier at the Marion Shrine in Knock, Mr. Biden had an emotional chance meeting with former US Army Chaplain Father Frank O'Grady, who performed the last rites on Beau Biden. Father O'Grady told RTÉ News that he had not seen Mr. Biden since that time.
Himself and his son, Hunter, and also his sister, we had a nice chat for about 10 minutes. He gave me a big hug, and Hunter gave me a big hug. And we talked a little bit about grief, about the fact that years can dissipate some grief, but there's some griefs that take years and years to get over. And I think he's handling it okay. He was emotional today, and I told him, you know, that he was a person of great faith, and he said his faith sustains him.
Introducing Mr. Biden in Ballina, Taoiseach Leo Varadkar thanked Mr. Biden for what he said was his lifelong commitment to peace on the island of Ireland and efforts to build a better future here in America and the world. Mr. Varadkar said Mayo is home to American companies who provide good jobs for so many and a new technological university which provides the greatest passport of all, an education. The first meeting of the Citizens' Assembly on drug use is getting underway in Malahide in Dublin this morning. The Assembly has been established to consider the legislative policy and operational changes Ireland could make to significantly reduce the harmful impacts of illicit drugs on society. Our Social Affairs correspondent, Alva Keneally.
In February, the government announced the establishment of a citizens' assembly on drugs use. 100 people, including 99 randomly chosen members of the public, led by chairperson Paul Reid, will examine the issue of drugs use in this country. They'll hear about the lived experience of people impacted by drugs, as well as their families and communities. They'll also look at international best practice. It's expected that they'll visit areas affected by drugs and hear from workers in addiction services on the ground. It's expected that a vote on recommendations by the Assembly will take place in October and that a final report will be submitted to government in December.
And that's it from the newsroom for now. Next news at 1.
Late date on RTÉ.
You're listening to RTÉ Radio 1 on Longwave 252. RTÉ Radio 1 is no longer available on Longwave. But don't worry, there are still lots of ways to listen to RTÉ Radio 1 and all of your favourite RTÉ radio services. In Ireland, you can continue to listen on FM, on Serviu and Sersat, and on your preferred streaming service. In the UK, you can listen on Freesat, channel 750, Sky, channel 0137, and Virgin Media, channel 917, although this may depend on your Virgin Media box. You can also listen on the RTÉ Radio Player app and on your preferred audio streaming service. Just visit rte.ie/keep listening to see the range of listening options available. You can also phone the RTÉ Information Service on +353 1208 3434. That's +353 1208 3434. Thank you for listening. You're listening to RTÉ Radio 1 on Longwave 252. RTÉ Radio 1 is no longer available on Longwave. But don't worry, there are still lots of ways to listen to RTÉ Radio 1 and all of your favourite RTÉ radio services. In Ireland, you can continue to listen on FM, on Serviu and Sersat, and on your preferred streaming service. In the UK, you can listen on Freesat, channel 750, Sky, channel 0137, and Virgin Media, channel 917, although this may depend on your Virgin Media box. You can also listen on the RTÉ Radio Player app and on your preferred audio streaming service. Just visit rte.ie/keep listening to see the range of listening options available. You can also phone the RTÉ Information Service on +353 1208 3434. That's +353 1208 3434. Thank you for listening. You're listening to RTÉ Radio 1 on Longwave 252. RTÉ Radio 1 is no longer available on Longwave. But don't worry, there are still lots of ways to listen to RTÉ Radio 1 and all of your favourite RTÉ radio services. In Ireland, you can continue to listen on FM, on Serview and Sersat, and on your preferred streaming service. In the UK, you can listen on Freesat, channel 750, Sky, channel 0137, and Virgin Media, channel 917, although this may depend on your Virgin Media box. You can also listen on the RTÉ Radio Player app and on your preferred audio streaming service. Just visit rte.ie/keep listening to see the range of listening options available. You can also phone the RTÉ Information Service on +353 1208 3434. That's +353 1208 3434. Thank you for listening.